Hello everyone, welcome to Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series. So in this section we will be discussing about various antimicrobial and their treatment and their drug of choice, and it will be a very quick revision, and the full treatment is already given in the relevant section of our Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series full videos. So let's start with treatment of various infection. So first we will be starting with how to treat gram positive infection or gram positive bacterias. After that we will come to gram negative, atypical bacterias, fungal, protozoal, etc. So let's start with a quick revision of gram positive bacteria. So the first bacteria we will be writing is Streptococcus pneumoniae. So it's a gram positive bacteria. The treatment of Streptococcus pneumoniae depends upon the type of infection. Streptococcus pneumoniae causes meningitis. Other invasive infection, rather going into the brain, or very mild otitis media. It is the most common cause of otitis media or ENT infections. Let's see how to treat them. If it is meningitis, the drug of choice is vancomycin in combination with cefotaxime. And if the patient is allergic to penicillin like cefotaxime, then in that case you can, instead of cefotaxime allergy, you can give rifampicin. For invasive infection, the drug of choice is penicillin G, okay, or you can give amoxicillin if it is not serious, because penicillin G is given by injection. Amoxicillin can be given orally. Okay, and if the person is allergic, you can give oral clindamycin, or you can also give vancomycin. Again, clindamycin is oral and vancomycin is by injection. Now otitis media, the drug of choice you already take very commonly when you suffer from sore throat is amoxicillin. Okay, so this is the treatment of Streptococcus pneumoniae. Let's come to next bacteria, that is Staphylococcus aureus. Now, Staphylococcus aureus is also known as superbug because it has developed resistance to many antibiotics. Let's see the treatment of Staphylococcus aureus. So the first point we will write is parenteral therapy. That means injectable drug. And injectable drug you give for serious infection. Second, we will write oral drugs which are effective. And oral drugs are given for non-serious infection like skin and soft tissue infection. And lastly, topical drug. Topical drug is given for skin infection like furunculosis, carbuncle, etc. caused. Let's talk about first parenteral therapy. The drug of choice for Staphylococcus aureus is penicillin G. But the problem is now Staphylococcus is producing resistance because it is producing one enzyme, penicillinase. So if it is penicillinase producing Staphylococcus aureus, you will give penicillinase resistant penicillin like nafisilin, oxacillin, etc. But the problem is now it has become resistant to penicillinase resistant penicillin also. Again, we will write resistance. That Staphylococcus aureus is known as MRSA. That stands for methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. In this case, the drug of choice is injections of vancomycin. So what is the drug of choice for MRSA? Vancomycin. Now, there is a big problem that this Staphylococcus has become resistant to vancomycin also. This is known as VRSA, vancomycin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. Here the drug of choice now has become daptomycin. But if a question comes, if there is VRSA pneumonia, daptomycin is not effective. In cases of VRSA pneumonia, the drug of choice is linezolid. The drug of choice is linezolid or a new congener tedizolid. Now what are the other drugs which are effective for MRSA type of bacteria? For other VRSA, we have streptogramins, we have tigecycline, we have fifth generation cephalosporin, the only beta lactam which is effective, like ceftaroline. Okay, ceftaroline. So try to remember this drug. Now let's talk about oral drugs for skin and soft tissue infection. We will write the drugs are, we will start with dicloxacillin most commonly because it's an oral drug, and if it is MRSA we can give rifampicin, clindamycin, cotrimoxazole, doxycycline. Okay, and the topical drug for MRSA, it's a very important question, you will write mupirocin cream. Mupirocin cream, which is given as a 2% cream. Now we will write two additional very recent point. There is a new drug for MRSA. The drug name is lifamulin. Now the second question which has recently been asked, which drug is not effective in MRSA? The drug which is not effective in MRSA starts from M only, macrolides. Macrolides are not effective against MRSA. Macrolides are erythromycin, azithromycin. Okay, so try to remember the full treatment of MRSA. It's a very commonly asked question. Let's move ahead. Other streptococcal infection we will write. So all other streptococcal infection, let's write what are the different streptococci we have and their treatment. The first streptococci we will write Streptococcus pyogenes. Second, group C or group G streptococci. Okay, Streptococci A galactaceae, okay, group D streptococci. Remember, group D streptococci are anaerobics, they are anaerobic streptococci. Now in all these cases the drug of choice is penicillin G, or you can use a long acting congener of penicillin G, that is benzathine penicillin. It is the longest acting penicillin. Okay, now in cases of allergy we use erythromycin. It's a very commonly asked question, or azithromycin. Lastly, for this group D anaerobic streptococci, you can use one drug which has been asked recently, that is clindamycin. So this is a question which I have recently been asked, so please mark them in your notes. They have been asked very commonly. Okay, let's move ahead. Let's talk about next gram positive bacteria, that is enterococcal species or Enterococcus bacteria, very resistant bacteria present in our gut also, which causes hospital acquired infection. Now for enterococcal infection there are two species. First is Enterococcal faecalis, second is Enterococcal faecium. Faecium is very resistant bacteria. Now for the treatment of Enterococcal faecalis, the drug of choice is ampicillin, plus you can add gentamicin. But if one question will come, you will go by ampicillin. Now in cases of resistance, instead of ampicillin you will add vancomycin, plus continue with G for gentamicin. Now what about Enterococcal faecium? Enterococcal faecium is resistant to these bacteria, these antimicrobial. It is resistant to ampicillin, it is resistant to vancomycin. For Enterococcal faecium you give daptomycin as a drug of choice, along with gentamicin, G for gentamicin. Okay, and similarly if there is vancomycin resistance, you will give daptomycin plus gentamicin. So this is the treatment of enterococcal bacteria. Okay, now enterococcal is very commonly causes UTI. Because of Foley's catheter, it can cause UTI, which is known as catheter associated UTI by enterococcal bacteria. Now Here the drug of choice is phosphomycin. Here the drug of choice is phosphomycin. Okay, let's move ahead to the next bacteria, that is Corynebacterium diphtheriae. Although now the infection has recently been reduced to, it has rarely seen because of immunization. But if a patient of Corynebacterium diphtheriae comes to you, the drug of choice is erythromycin. But you can also use penicillin G. Okay. Now, a very commonly asked question, if it is resistant to penicillin G or erythromycin, the treatment is rifampicin. This is a recently asked question, and you can add to this drug clindamycin. So please encircle these drugs. They are very commonly asked question. Rifampicin is also asked. So this is the treatment of Corynebacterium diphtheriae. Let's come to the next question. Next bacteria, next gram-positive bacteria, that is Listeria monocytogenes. Okay, it very commonly causes meningitis. And here the drug of choice is ampicillin. Okay. Plus you can add, so ampicillin is the drug of choice, plus you can add gentamicin. Gentamicin increases the effectiveness of ampicillin. And if it is allergic to penicillin, you can give cotrimoxazole. Okay, now very important question. Generally for meningitis, we use cephalosporin, but cephalosporins are not effective against Listeria. So you have to give, are not effective. So that is why in cases of meningitis, we give ampicillin because of this specific bacteria. Otherwise, all other bacteria's meningitis, we use cephalosporin like ceftriaxone, ciprofloxacin. Okay. So cephalosporins are not effective against Listeria monocytogenes. Let's come to gram-positive bacteria, further gram-positive bacteria, that is Clostridium. Clostridium bacteria, which is an anaerobic gram-positive bacteria. So the first infection caused by Clostridium is tetanus, caused by Clostridium tetani. Here the drug of choice is metronidazole. Why? Because it is an anaerobic bacteria. For anaerobes, we give metronidazole IV or rectally. If veins are not available, you can give. What is the alternative? Alternative is penicillin G. But the drug of choice is metronidazole. And similar is the exact treatment for botulinum toxin also. Botulinum caused by Clostridium botulini. Now remember, these are the antimicrobial agent, but the mainstay of treatment of tetanus and botulini is to give. Mainstay of treatment should be give antitoxin. If a patient comes, give antitoxin. Antitoxin is the life-saving thing in cases of clostridial infection, but to kill the bacteria you give tetanus and botulinum, you give metronidazole. Now one more species is of Clostridium which causes gas gangrene. This infection is also known as myonecrosis. It is caused by Clostridium perfringens. Now here the drug of choice is penicillin G. And you will add clindamycin. Now the question comes, why we give clindamycin? Clindamycin is added to reduce toxin production. We give clindamycin. And similarly, there is one more bacteria which causes deaths or complication due to production of toxin. That is toxic shock syndrome toxin. Now here again the drug of choice is vancomycin to kill the bacteria, but remember the death is due to toxin production. To reduce toxin production you give clindamycin. To kill the bacteria you give vancomycin. To decrease toxin production you give clindamycin. This is a very commonly asked question, please mark it. So clindamycin in all these bacteria reduces toxin production. Now last bacteria related to Clostridium is Clostridium difficile. Clostridium difficile causes pseudomembranous colitis. and the cause of Clostridium difficile is because of antibiotic usage. So it is antibiotic associated diarrhea. Why? Because when you use antibiotic, the good bacteria in our colon gets killed and this harmful bacteria grows. Now the drug of choice for Clostridium difficile infection is oral or rectal vancomycin. Now remember, oral or rectal word is also important because vancomycin is not absorbed orally. So when you give vancomycin, it will just kill the bacteria present in our colon. The second drug you can give is metronidazole. Earlier it was the drug of choice, but now the drug of choice has become vancomycin. Metronidazole is only given in mild infection and children. So overall, more effective drug is vancomycin. Third drug recently been approved is fidaxomicin. And one monoclonal antibody approved against Clostridium difficile infection is bezlotoxumab. This question has been asked. So these drugs you have to remember, and Clostridium difficile is a very commonly asked question. Okay, so this is all about gram positive bacteria, and now we will be discussing about gram negative bacteria. So now let's start with the infections of gram negative bacteria. So we have already discussed gram positive. Let's see various gram negative bacteria and their treatment. So the first bacteria we will write is Neisseria meningitidis. And we know it causes meningitis. So for the treatment of meningitis, the drug of choice is third generation cephalosporin like ceftriaxone, which is a better drug than penicillin G. Okay. Now we know that Neisseria meningitidis, it has nasal carrier sheet. So to kill this nasal colonization, the most effective drug is ceftriaxone, which is given by injections. But according to WHO, the drug of choice is ciprofloxacin, which can be given orally. The other drugs which are effective are rifampicin and clindamycin. Now there was a question in which both ciprofloxacin and rifampicin was asked for the treatment of nasal carrier sheet of Neisseria meningitidis. In that case, you will go by ciprofloxacin. Okay. Next bacteria is Neisseria gonococci. Neisseria gonorrhea, which causes gonorrhea. Now for the treatment of Neisseria gonorrhea, the drug of choice is again ceftriaxone by injections. Okay, now there is a problem with ceftriaxone. If a person is allergic to ceftriaxone, or this gonorrhea is penicillinase producing Neisseria gonorrhea, PPNG, in that case, the drug of choice, you have to remember a very important drug, one aminoglycoside like drug, spectinomycin. Okay, and we can also use in resistant cases azithromycin. Now the treatment of gonorrhea is with ceftriaxone. We generally combine azithromycin because of widespread resistance. We very commonly give azithromycin as a combination. Okay, the other drugs which are effective are gentamicin and gemifloxacin. Now let's move ahead. Third gram negative bacteria we will write is Haemophilus influenzae. It causes variety of diseases or infection. Let's see its treatment. If it causes meningitis, which is an emergency, or epiglottitis, again an emergency, the drug of choice in that case is ceftriaxone, or you can use cefotaxime, similar drug, third generation cephalosporin. If it is causing ENT or respiratory infection, you can use mild drugs like amoxicillin, clavulanic acid. Okay. And in cases of allergy to amoxicillin, you can give azithromycin. So this is the treatment of Haemophilus influenza. So Marquette, a very commonly asked. Next is Haemophilus Dukeri. Now Haemophilus Dukeri causes sexually transmitted disease which is known as chancroid. And the drug of choice for the treatment of Haemophilus Dukeri is azithromycin. 1 gram, single dose. Okay, you will write there is no role of cotrimoxazole. This question has been asked. Cotrimoxazole is not effective against Haemophilus Dukeri. Let's move ahead. We will write Moraxella Ceterellis. Drug of choice is amoxicillin clavulanic acid. Let's write the short form as amoxiclav. Sixth, Hecate group of bacteria. Here the drug of choice is ceftriaxone. Sixth, Legionella, which causes pneumonia through aerosols. For Legionella pneumonia, the drug of choice is macrolides. Remember here, there is no role of penicillin or ceftriaxone. They are resistant to it, like azithromycin. Now, Legionella may also cause infection in organ transplant patient. The problem is, macrolides should not be given in organ transplant patient. Here we give fluoroquinolones. Here we give fluoroquinolone because macrolides, they interfere with the immunity of the patient. Okay. Eighth, Bordetella pertussis, which causes whooping cough. Okay. Bordetella pertussis, which causes whooping cough. We have immunization also for this Bordetella. Here the drug of choice is again macrolides, like erythromycin, azithromycin, etc. So it's a very commonly asked question. Please mark it. Erythro or azithromycin. You can use any of them. And you will write, they are also the drug of choice for prophylaxis also. For prevention also, they are the drug of choice. Both for treatment and prevention of Bordetella pertussis, the drug of choice is macrolides. Okay, and if the patient is allergic to macrolides, you can give cotrimoxazole. Okay, let's come to a very big group of gram-negative bacteria, that is Enterobacteriaceae. Group. It has various bacteria. Let's write the name of those bacteria and their treatment. First is Escherichia coli. Now, if Escherichia coli is causing cystitis or UTI, it is the most common cause of UTI in the world. E. coli, 70% cases of UTI is because of E. coli. Drug of choice is cotrimoxazole. But apart from cotrimoxazole, if there is resistance, you can use fluoroquinolones like ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin, etc. Okay, you can also use nitrofurantoin, which is a urinary antiseptic. You can use fosfomycin, which is again a urinary antiseptic. They are given for chronic UTIs. And if it is still resistance, you can give a very new drug, a reserve drug, tigecycline. Okay, now E. coli is also the most common cause of traveler's diarrhea. Now for traveler's diarrhea, we will use fluoroquinolones like ciprofloxacin. Okay, and the second drug you can give is macrolides like erythromycin, azithromycin. So we very commonly give azithromycin. Let's talk about a very resistant bacteria, that is Klebsiella. Klebsiella is also known as superbug. It is resistant to most of the antibiotic. So we use a reserve drug that is carbapenems. Like imipenem, meropenem, etc. So they are the drug of choice for Klebsiella. And we add aminoglycoside to increase their effectiveness, amikacin. Okay, so if drug of choice is asked, you will go by carbapenems. And if it is still resistant, this is known as MDR. MDR is multi-drug resistant Klebsiella. In this case, you give tigecycline. Okay, or you can also use polymyxin group of antibiotic, that is colistin. So they are resistant cases. These drugs are the drugs of last resort. Colistin is considered as a drug of last resort. After this, we don't have any drug. We'll write Proteus. For Proteus, again, the drug of choice is carbapenems nowadays. Again, a very resistant bacteria. And we will add amikacin. Okay. You can also give, in allergic cases of carbapenem, you can give cotrimoxazole. Okay, cotrimoxazole. For UTI, you can give fosfomycin. For UTI, you can give fosfomycin. Then we will write Enterobacter. For Enterobacter, again, the drug of choice is carbapenems. Okay, which is given by injection. Or you can give ciprofloxacin orally. So if it is a serious infection, you will give carbapenems. If it is a non-serious infection, give ciprofloxacin orally. Okay, then we will write other drugs where the carbapenem is considered drug of choice. We will write Citrobacter. Morganella, Providentia. So same treatment, same treatment. Then we will write Advertsiella, here the drug of choice is fluoroquinolones like ciprofloxacin. Okay, and in resistant cases you will give carbapenems. In resistant cases, you will give carbapenems. Okay. Next is Acinetobacter, a very important infection. Nowadays, it is asked very commonly. Acinetobacter baumannii. Please mark it. It is a very frequently asked question. Acinetobacter baumannii. For Acinetobacter baumannii, the drug of choice is carbapenems. Carbapenems. Along with, okay, carbapenems. The second drug you can give is sulbactam. The question which was asked recently was, there is an Acinetobacter baumannii which is resistant to carbapenem. That is MDR Acinetobacter baumannii, which is known as multi-drug resistant. Here you will give colistin, which is considered as a drug of choice. The second drug you can give is tigecycline. Second drug you can give is tigecycline. Then we will come to gram-negative bacteria which causes peptic ulcers. Helicobacter pylori. Okay, it causes peptic ulcers, it causes gastritis, it causes cancers like maltomas also. So here we give proton pump inhibitor with clarithromycin with one drug from amoxicillin or metronidazole, any one drug among them, for 14 days. And all drugs are given twice a day BD, and this is known as triple therapy. So among proton pump inhibitor, you can use omeprazole, pantoprazole. Now other drugs which are effective, so we will write certain antimicrobial list which is effective. The question which is asked, which antimicrobials are effective against Helicobacter pylori, make a mnemonic CAMTEL. C for clarithromycin, we have already written. Amoxicillin, metronidazole, tetracycline, levofloxacin. Please convert CAMTEL R, rifabutin, recently been approved drug for H. pylori is rifabutin. So this is the full mnemonic CAMTEL R. These are the list of antimicrobials which are effective against Helicobacter pylori. Let's come to Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Now, the drug of choice for Pseudomonas aeruginosa is a combination of piperacillin with tazobactam to prevent resistance, and combine them with gentamicin. Okay. Instead of piperacillin, you can also give ceftazidime, third generation cephalosporin with gentamicin. Now, if it is resistant, start carbapenems. If it is still resistant, the drug of last resort is colistin. Now for Pseudomonas aeruginosa, all these drugs which we have written are by injections. Any oral drug for Pseudomonas? Yes. The oral drug of choice for Pseudomonas aeruginosa is ciprofloxacin. Okay, ciprofloxacin is an oral drug. Next we will write Streno, Trophomonas, Maltopia. A gram-negative bacteria just like Pseudomonas. Here the drug of choice is cotrimoxazole. And if it is still resistant, add ticarcillin. Then we will write a very important, please mark it, Burkholderia capsica. Burkholderia capsica. So nowadays many questions are coming on this bacteria. Okay, Burkholderia. Earlier it was considered to be Pseudomonas. Now you will write first point. There is no role of, we will write it, that means it is resistant to aminoglycoside. This question has been asked. It is resistant to third generation cephalosporin. Question has been asked. And colistin, this year's question, 2019 question. Okay, Burkholderia capsica is resistant to all this antimicrobial, because these antimicrobial were used for the treatment of Pseudomonas. Earlier it was considered to be Pseudomonas, and these drug of choice for Pseudomonas are not effective against Burkholderia. So what is the treatment? Now the drug of choice is cotrimoxazole, plus you can also add doxycycline. Now if it is a serious infection, life-threatening infection, then you use fourth generation cephalosporin along with carbapenems. The combination of fourth generation cephalosporin like cefepime with imipenem, meropenem, etc. is the treatment of Burkholderia capsica. Another species of Burkholderia we will write, that is Burkholderia pseudomallei, which causes melidiosis. Okay, here for induction, when a patient comes with an infection, for induction we give ceftazidime, which is a third generation cephalosporin. For maintenance, up to 6 months we continue with cotrimoxazole. Okay, then we will write a very important infection which causes typhoid, that is Salmonella typhi, which causes typhoid. Now for empirical treatment, if you don't know whether this typhoid is resistant to any drug, empirically you will start ceftriaxone, which is now considered to be the drug of choice, and add azithromycin. Okay, for the treatment of typhoid, start. Now the point is, if drug sensitivity test is available, initially we start with ciprofloxacin. If it is resistant to ciprofloxacin, we start ceftriaxone, okay, with azithromycin in all cases. Okay, so ciprofloxacin, now it has become resistant to ciprofloxacin, that is why we straight away start with ceftriaxone, which is considered as a drug of choice. Now we know that Salmonella typhi has a carrier state in a gallbladder. To kill carrier state, we start with ciprofloxacin. Another drug which you can give is amoxicillin, very commonly asked. You can also give cotrimoxazole. So you have to remember them. Okay, now remember, in Salmonella typhi there is no role of aminoglycosides. One question has been asked that there is one aminoglycoside, amikacin. So question comes, aminoglycosides are not effective against typhoid. This is a very commonly asked question. Let's move ahead. The brother of Salmonella is Shigella. The treatment of Shigella, the drug of choice is ciprofloxacin. And in cases of resistance, you can start ceftriaxone. So same like Salmonella we give. Then we will write Campylobacterium or Campylobacter. Drug of choice is erythromycin. Okay, now then very important, Vibrio cholera, which causes cholera. So please mark it, very commonly asked. The mainstay of cholera treatment is give ORS or fluid replacement. That is a life-saving process. But if you will talk about the treatment, the drug of choice is doxycycline. But remember, doxycycline is contraindicated in pregnancy. It is contraindicated in children less than 8 years of age. And the drug which can be given everywhere is, now more commonly used drug for Vibrio cholerae is azithromycin. Azithromycin is safe in pregnancy, it is safe in children less than 8 years of age. Lastly, for prevention or prophylaxis, so we have to give mass prophylaxis to the whole community. You can give tetracycline for the prophylaxis of Vibrio cholerae. You can also give, which is considered as a drug of choice, you can also give ciprofloxacin. Okay, next infection we will write brucellosis. Brucellosis. Now brucellosis causes an infection known as undulant fever. For undulant fever, the treatment is streptomycin. The drug of choice is streptomycin and add doxycycline. If both question will come, you have to write streptomycin as a drug of choice. And in resistant cases, you will add rifampicin. For prevention of brucellosis, the drug of choice is doxycycline. Okay, you can also give rifampicin. Then the second infection we will write is tularemia, which is caused by Francisella tularensis. Here the drug of choice is gentamicin. You can also give streptomycin, a aminoglycoside, but gentamicin is more effective. Okay, gentamicin is more effective. Then we will write plague that is caused by Yersinia pestis, which causes plague. Now here the drug of choice for plague is streptomycin, and you can also use gentamicin. So reverse it. Okay, then we will write other drug for prophylaxis. For prophylaxis of Yersinia pestis or plague, the drug of choice is levofloxacin. You can also use other drugs like doxycycline. Okay, then a brother of Yersinia pestis, that is Yersinia enterocolitica, which does not cause plague, which rather causes food poisoning. Here the drug of choice is ciprofloxacin. Then we will write Bartonella. Bartonella causes a disease known as cat scratch disease. And the drug of choice for Bartonella overall is doxycycline. Okay? Now Bartonella can infect many organs of the brain of the body, like it may cause retinitis. Okay, drug of choice for retinitis, doxycycline. It causes trench fever. For trench fever, again the drug of choice, doxycycline. It also causes endocarditis. Now it also causes endocarditis, drug of choice is doxycycline. It also causes bacillary angiomatosis, which is also known as peliosis. Again, the drug of choice is doxycycline. Okay. Now, it causes lymphadenopathy. Now, if it is lymphadenopathy, then the drug of choice is azithromycin. If it causes lymphadenopathy, because it occurs in small children, it causes Oroya fever. For Oroya fever, you give chloramphenicol. Okay, it may also cause Verruca peruana. For here, you will give rifampicin with streptomycin. Okay, so these are the variety of infection caused by Bartonella cat scratch disease. Next infection we will write is Chemylobacterium granulomatis. It causes one sexually transmitted disease known as donovanosis. And the drug of choice is azithromycin, which is a better drug than doxycycline or tetracycline group. Okay, earlier doxycycline was the drug of choice. Next is Nocardia. Nocardia, drug of choice is cotrimoxazole. Okay, actinomycosis. Israeli. Now this is a very commonly asked question, please mark it. Drug of choice is penicillin G. Whipple disease. Whipple disease, you know, is caused by Treponema. Okay, and here again the drug of choice is cotrimoxazole. Okay, then let's talk about spirochete infection. Now for the spirochetal infection, the first we will write is syphilis, which is caused by Treponema pallidum. Okay. Now, the drug of choice for syphilis is benzathine penicillin. Okay. Benzathine penicillin, you will write all stages of syphilis. And the dose, route, which has been already discussed in penicillin group of chapter. So, please refer to the videos of penicillin, where we have discussed the great detail, in great detail, the treatment of syphilis. Now, it is effective in all stages of syphilis except one syphilis. This is a very commonly asked question. Benzathine penicillin is not effective in neurosyphilis. In neurosyphilis, the drug of choice is aqueous penicillin. So, benzathine penicillin is not effective in neurosyphilis. Now, there are two types of aqueous penicillin. One is penicillin G and the second is procaine penicillin. Okay. Now, in allergic cases of penicillin, we give doxycycline. In allergic cases of penicillin, we give doxycycline. Okay. And remember, same is the treatment of Treponema pertinuum, which causes an infection known as yaws. It has been eradicated from India. Next spirochete we will write is leptospirosis, a very common infection in India. Now, the drug of choice for leptospirosis is doxycycline. And doxycycline is a drug of choice for both treatment as well as prevention. Okay. If it is a very severe disease or life-threatening disease, add penicillin G if it is a life-threatening disease. Then we will write Borrelia recurrentis. Which causes a disease known as relapsing fever. Okay, Borrelia recurrentis. Now, Borrelia recurrentis is of two types. It could be louse-borne. It could be tick-borne. Irrespective, the drug of choice is doxycycline. Okay, and the second choice of drug which you can give is erythromycin. Okay, erythromycin. If this Borrelia is causing meningitis, in that case, the drug of choice is ceftriaxone. Okay, ceftriaxone. Let's talk about another species of Borrelia, that is Borrelia burgdorferi. Now, Borrelia burgdorferi, it causes infection known as Lyme's disease. Now, the drug of choice for Borrelia burgdorferi is doxycycline, which is the drug of choice. Second choice of a drug is amoxicillin. Third choice of a drug is cefuroxime. And the fourth choice of a drug is erythromycin. But you have to remember this part, doxycycline. Sometimes this Borrelia burgdorferi causes meningitis. And it may also causes encephalitis or neuropathy. Now, this is a life-threatening infection. If it is causing meningitis, the drug of choice is ceftriaxone. Ceftriaxone. Second choice of a drug is cefotaxime. Third choice of a drug is penicillin G. So try to remember ceftriaxone. Okay. Now let's talk about atypical bacteria that lack cell wall. Now atypical bacteria, they lack cell wall. And because of this reason, there is no role of beta lactams. Among beta lactams, you have penicillin, cephalosporin, etc. Why? Because penicillin and cephalosporin, they kill cell wall. Okay, there is also no role of vancomycin, which is also a cell wall inhibitor. So let's see those atypical bacterias. The first is rickettsia. Now, for all types of rickettsial infection, the drug of choice is doxycycline. And if it is causing meningitis, the drug of choice is chloramphenicol. Okay. Then we will write ehrlichiosis, anaplasmosis, atypical bacteria that lack cell wall, Q fever caused by Coxiella burnetii. Okay. Again, everywhere the drug of choice is doxycycline. Now, these infections can occur in pregnancy also. In that case, you will give cotrimoxazole because doxycycline is contraindicated in pregnancy. Then, an atypical bacteria where penicillin, cephalosporin are not effective, that is mycoplasma that lacks cell wall. The drug of choice for mycoplasma, pneumoniae, one species. Mycoplasma genitalium. Urea plasma. Everywhere the drug of choice is macrolides like azithromycin. Okay, except one where macrolides are not effective, that is Mycoplasma hominis. So here there is no role of macrolide. Here the drug of choice is doxycycline. So this question has been asked. So overall, drug of choice for Mycoplasma pneumoniae is azithromycin, hominis is doxycycline. Try to remember it. It's a commonly asked question. Now let's talk about last atypical bacteria, that is Chlamydia. Now Chlamydia, the first species we will write is Chlamydia trachomatis, which causes variety of disease. It causes trachoma. It causes sexually transmitted disease. And here the drug of choice is azithromycin. 1 gram single dose. Plus you can add, so drug of choice is azithromycin. You can add or you can give doxycycline. And doxycycline is given 100 milligram for 7 days. So now the drug of choice for trachoma is azithromycin. Next infection caused by Chlamydia is psittacosis. Okay, it also causes pneumonia, Chlamydia pneumonia. And in these cases, the drug of choice is tetracycline. So this completes our all bacterial infection. The remaining mycobacterial infections has been already covered in our lectures of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, leprae, etc. So this is all about the treatment of antibacterials or antimicrobial drug of choice. So thank you very much.